20, 30 years ago, everyone was saying, oh, let's do a nature reserve, take humans out of the formula. No, it doesn't work that way, because we are part and parcel of nature. Botanic Garden is a very dynamic part of Jordan. It has evolved over the 25 years since I first started. I could clearly see the destruction of our habitats.
On the site at that time was overgrazing, lack of vegetation cover.
I realized we have to develop our scientific base. We have to develop our human capacity to be able to address this issue, which as each day passes, it was getting worse and worse.
Not all the herder is ready to cooperate. They have some concern related to losing the grazing on the land.
سكر المنطقة هذه من حوالي 40 سنة وقبل أهلي كانوا ساكنين فيها.
والله كانت يعني ما في عمار زي هيك ضعيف والزرع ضعيف
بداية الأمر كنا يعني مصعبين شوي
Our mission is to cooperate together to enhance the biodiversity and the productivity of the site.
كانوا يعطونا أعلاف وقالوا لنا إنه اللي بترعوهن في الربيع بترعوهن في الصيف موجودات يعني ما راع لكم شيء ومشينا معهم والله والأمور ماشية كويسة
We did not come out of nothing. This is an evolution of tens of thousands of years of civilizations that lived and walked these very same lands that we sit in today. As a child, my parents, especially my father, would take me out to the desert. He would tell me that what you see is not dead, it's very much alive. But you have to learn how to read it and feel it and understand where you are. And that was the first, so to speak, awakening in developing the relationship between me and nature and the land that we come from. Whenever we traveled, we'd go to and visit botanic gardens across the globe, and no one did a botanic garden in Jordan. So I thought, okay, I may as well do it myself. And I wanted it deliberately at the time to be for our native plants. I wanted to develop the resources and fill the gap that was there. The main concern of the herding community was we were taking away one of the largest parcels of rangelands they had to graze on. They've been here for thousands of years. It's their land as much as it is ours.
بتعني إننا عايشين فيها ومتوسعين فيها وبنزرع فيها وبنسرح فيها وقريبنا فيها ومرتاحين فيها
سكننا في هذه المنطقة سنة 73 كان ما في مواصلات ولا في سيارات ولا في شيء جددت أنا شريت في سنة 2000 شريت 60 راس صار الحمد لله قطيع صار كويس يعني لحق 300-400 الحمد لله رب العالمين لغاية الآن يعني
مع المحمية صارت على من تحت والمناطق هذه كمان صارت توب يعني نقول ما ضيقنا ضيقنا ما في مجال اللي يعني نرحل في محل ثاني ولا نقدر نعيش فيه يعني
بداية يعني
لما سمعنا انه في حديقه بدات تسير بدرتنا مخاوف انه يعني ممكن ننمنع عن الرعي كون المنطقه يعني هي متنفسنا الوحيد ويعني مساحه الحديقه يعني كبيره يعني حوالي 80% من مساحه مراعينا اللي كنا نرعى فيها بحريه يعني على مدار اليوم او على مدار السنه.
لما شرينا القطيع يعني ما كان في حديقه، كان حراج.
Since the beginning, the Botanic Garden deal with our local community as a neighbor to share with them our knowledge and to benefit from their knowledge. The community-based rangeland rehabilitation program manage all these activities and keep the right of all partner on this. So we started in 2008 communicating with our neighbor and introduced our idea on that.
فبعديها بادرت الحديقة إنه يعني شو تجتمع معنا وتحكي لنا شو الهدف من إنشاء هذه الحديقة، فهذا الحكي طمنا شوية وقالوا إحنا يعني بنعوضكم شوية يعني بدل المناطق اللي حجزناها أو إن بنحميها مؤقتا يعني نعوضكم بدل علف أو مثلا في الصيف كنا يدخلونه في مناطق راعي
وبيدعونا هم كمان هما بيدعونا احنا يعني بنقول خلينا نشوف ونتقابل معهم نشوف ايش يسووا لينا ايش يعني هالمشكله اللي صارت معنا.
We set out to prevent grazing for over a 3-year period. To see how the land restores itself, what is the capacity. Nature is very smart. We don't understand it enough. So sometimes when we try to overcompensate, we actually ruin it. We as RBG had to compensate the herding community for that fodder. So we calculated the biomass and how much that would be.
The biomass is a term referred to the dry matter that's available to be grazed by the animal, and you can permit the grazing according to the biomass production. In general, it's like a holistic approach to keep the grazing site highly productive, highly biodiversity. The grazing is benefitable for the livestock more than the concentrated feed. Then we moved to establish the seed bank program and herbarium program, focusing on conserving the native flora of Jordan, which is already adapted and it's almost ready to adapt within the climate change and the global warming.
آه في نباتات ما كنا نشوفها قبل يعني في الآونة الأخيرة في زادت رغم إنه لأنه برا راعي جائر وما بتبين إنه بنشوفه. ففي الحديقة كنا نشوفها بحجمها ونوعيات أكثر.
أنا مسؤولة قسم المعشبة. المعشبة عبارة عن مكان لحفظ العينات النباتية.
The herbarium is like a flora library that hosts the plant specimen.
تضمن وتحتوي على النباتات البرية المحلية الموجودة عندنا بالأردن. عندنا في معشبتنا ما يقارب أكثر من 7000 عينة. هلأ لما تكون مرجعية نقدر إحنا نوعي الناس بالأنواع اللي مهددة بالانقراض والنادرة ومنورجيهم هاي العينات وهاي النباتات وبيتم على أساسها النشر الوعي حتى نزرع هاي النباتات ونكثرها مختلف مناطق المملكة.
The seed bank is a unit specialized in collection, documentation, and preservation plant seed, especially local and rare native species. Here is the seed bank and short-term storage. Here we have more than 20 million seeds.
In the first plant service that we did across the land here in the site, it was around 350 different plants. Today we have over 600 somewhat plants growing just from the soil seed bank, so you can imagine how resilient our land is. For me, that was a beacon of hope.
يعني زاد النمو غطاء النبات زاد فيها. فهذا الحكي يعني في الصيف كنا يعني بنلاقيه إنه في إيش في فترة طويلة بنرعى في الصيف. الحكي هذا يعني نفعنا إنه إيش في صار غطاء نباتي كونها محمية في منطقة الربيع والشتاء. ففي الصيف بنلاقي فيها إيش مراعي.
والله استفاد البال المحمية، في ناس استفاد، ناس أبوين استفاد أنا اشتغلن فيها. وإن شاء الله الله الجايات أحسن من اللي راح.
There's abundance, there's resilience, and there's absolutely a lot of hope for the future. I'm very proud to say that the Royal Botanic Garden of Jordan has redefined the modern role of botanic gardens. We have to reach out to the local communities. We have to work together because it's all ours.
Thanks so much for watching. For more videos like this, subscribe to the United Nations Environment Programme.